Hello everyone, today we will discuss a small topic related to the forms of parabola. In other words, we are going to see the relation between the standard form of a parabola and the vertex form of a parabola. We already know the standard form of a parabola, which is given by y is equals to ax square plus bx plus c, where this a, b, c belongs to real and a not equal to 0. From this standard form, we will try to derive the vertex form of a parabola. Now from this equation, we know that the coordinate of the vertex of a parabola is vertex will be x coordinate will be minus b by 2a and y coordinate will be c minus b square by 4a. This we already seen in the previous lecture. Now let us denote this coordinate of the vertex as h comma k. Okay, so our h will be nothing but minus b by 2a and k will be c minus b square by 4a. We have obtained the required data. Now let us start deriving. We have y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. I will take a common from these two terms. I will get a times x square plus b by a times x plus c. Also, I will add and subtract b square by 4a square to this term. I will get a times x square plus b by a x plus b square by 4a square and minus b square by 4a square plus c. Right? Now, also I will multiply with the 2 and divide by 2 here. Now I will rewrite this. A times x square plus 2 times x times b by 2a plus, I will write this b square by 4a square as like this, b by 2a whole square and minus b square by 4a square plus c. So if we observe this, x square plus 2 times x plus 2 times x times b by 2a plus b by 2a square, this is in the form of p square plus 2p cube plus q square. We can write this as p plus q whole square. So writing like that, we get x plus b by 2a whole square minus b square by 4a square plus c. Now if I multiply a, we get a times x plus b by 2a whole square minus a times b square by 4a square plus c. A and this get cancelled. Finally, I will obtain, this will be equal to a times x plus b by 2a whole square plus c minus b square by 4a. If we observe, c minus b square by 4a is k here and b by 2a will be minus h. So if we substitute h and k in this equation, we get y is equal to a times x minus h whole square plus k. This is the vertex form. Vertex form of the parabola, where this h comma k is the coordinate of the vertex of the given parabola. This is the standard form, and from this standard form we derived the vertex form. So we have got the vertex form of a parabola, which will be like this: a times x minus h whole square plus k, where h comma k is the vertex of the parabola. Now let us see one example to understand this vertex form clearly. So suppose we have an equation of a parabola given like this: y is equal to 3x square plus 6x plus 9. Now we try to write in vertex form. So I will take 3 common from the first two terms. I will get x square plus 2x plus 9. So in order to make this a perfect square, I will add 1 and subtract 1. So 3 times x square plus 2x plus 1 minus 1 plus 9. So 3 times, this can be written as x plus 1 whole square minus 1 plus 9. 3 times x plus 1 whole square minus, if I multiply 3, minus 3 plus 9, which gives us 3 times x minus minus 1 whole square plus 6. So we have got the equation y is equal to 3 times x minus minus 1 to the whole square plus 6. So if we equate it with the vertex form, we get h is equal to minus 1 and k is equal to 6. So our vertex will be at point minus 1 comma 6 is the vertex of the given parabola. So we will just cross verify it. We know that if we have a standard form, we can calculate the x coordinate of the vertex. So x coordinate of this vertex will be x is equal to minus b by 2a. So here b is 6 and a is 3. So if I substitute that, minus 6 by 2 times 3, which I will get x is equal to minus 1. And we know the y coordinate as c minus b square by 4a. Here we have c as 9 minus b is 6, so b square is 36 divided by 4 times a is 3. So 4 9s, 9 3s, so I will get 6. So my vertex point will be at minus 1 comma 6 if we solve through standard form also. Now let us see one more example. Find the equation of a parabola such that it passes through the origin and the vertex of the parabola is at 1 comma 2. So as we know the vertex form given by y is equal to a times x minus h whole square plus k. Here we have given that h comma k is nothing but 1 comma 2. So if we substitute that, our equation will be simplified to a times x minus 1 whole square plus 2. Also it is given that this equation passes through the origin. That means 0 comma 0 should satisfy this equation. So if we substitute it, we get the value of a. So 0 is equal to a times 0 minus 1 to the square plus 2. This implies 0 is equal to a times 1 minus 1 square plus 2. which implies again a is equal to minus 2. So our final equation of the parabola will be equal to y is equal to minus 2 times x minus 1 whole square plus 2. If you open that, minus 2 of x square minus 2x plus 1 plus 2, minus 2x square plus 4x minus 2 plus 2. So this will be get cancelled and 4x minus 2x square. So y is equal to 4x minus 2x square is the equation of the parabola that passes through the origin, and the vertex of this parabola will be at 1, 2. Thank you.